We publish our IMX every month, which is our investor movement index, which measures how people actually trade. So I found it very interesting when I looked at your chart, Steve, because as I saw the economic confidence, it very much lines up with what our clients do. Because on your chart, it looked like February through to the beginning of the fall, economic confidence was fairly high. When we saw our IMX, we saw people, it measures engagement with the market. People become more engaged at that time. Starting in October, and Wolf and I talk about this a lot, October, November, December, our clients actually drew down their engagement with the market in January. February, we saw them start to tick back up, but it's interesting in February how they did it. It wasn't necessarily about buying individual stocks. It was a lot more on broad-based ETFs and stocks that, you know, pay a higher dividend as people search for yield. So I think that it's really interesting to see how those two have lined up.
And JJ, what's your sense of what level cash levels are at for most of your portfolio?
Well, I would say this, as I say, there, compared to the last year and a half, people not nearly as engaged, so not putting as much cash to work, but starting to tick back up over the last month or so.
Kevin, when you look at the yield drop again this morning, back below 2.4 on the 10-year, does that concern you in your outlook for U.S. equities?
It doesn't. I mean, is it a telltale indicator of a forthcoming recession? Perhaps. But on average, that recession only starts 20 months thereafter that yield curve inverts. And I still think there's a lot of upside potential for this U.S. stock market. This survey actually provides even more credence towards that argument, right? Because consumer confidence leads to consumer spending. And as we know, consumer spending accounts for 70% of GDP growth. Is it below peak? It is, but that kind of supports the theme of slowing but growing. We expect the economy to continue to grow, not at the levels we saw last year, but certainly continue to grow. We expect earnings growth to continue to grow, not at 20% plus year-over-year earnings growth rate, but continue to grow. So I think this is very supportive of future stock market growth, at least in 2019.
And JJ, in terms of the biggest factors, do you think it is the Fed and yields or still the trade debate?
I still think it's tariffs overall. That outweighs everything, because you look at days that there is news. And when I know Steve, you want to jump in. When I see news come out and there's tariff news at the same time, tariff news always moves the market in a different way.
Jay, you know, I wanted to ask you a question about the gender gap. Do you see that in investing? When are women more? I think there's some data that show women are in general more cautious than men when it comes to
women
investing.
Women are more patient than men, and I think take their time and are. And a lot of this is anecdotal. Much more, here is my rules, and I'm sticking to my rules, and this is how I invest. And because of that, they tend to be more patient, where men are much more, I think there's perhaps, being a man, sometimes the men think they know a little bit better about what they're going to do.
Men twist their bodies to move the running back on the television. Women don't do that. But
I like that analogy.
Yeah, no, it's true. There's behavioral economics that show men think they're much more consequential in outcomes than women are. But when it comes to the order flow right now and what you see, are women ending up being more cautious? Do you have an ability to see that?
I don't really have that statistic at hand, Steve. But as I said, I do think that overall, I won't call it that women are more cautious. I think women plan much better what their investments will be. So when they go in, they're very much, here is my plan and I'm sticking to my plan. Men are much more reactionary.